Now, if you recall the cafe scenario, there is a Frank and Martha, they just set up a cafe, and in this particular lab, we are going to use our skills to make a static website for the cafe and host it in Amazon EC3. Then we will implement a method to protect our data using a lifecycle policy and data replication, and also with one of the features of EC3, which is EC3 versioning. Then we want to implement a disaster recovery strategy in Amazon EC3. And basically at the end of the lab, we will have the cafe website similar to this page here. And we have the main EC3 bucket, which is going to be hosted in the first region, and a second EC3 bucket, which is going to be hosted as a replication in another region. The first step is going to start the lab. I have already started my lab, so feel free to start the lab by now. And in the task one, we want to download this zip file to our computer. And once I open it, it's going to contain a static website, which has an index.html with a CSS file and with images for the cafe. First thing first is to access the AWS console. And here it's just complaining that I have another user in currently accessing AWS. So just let me make them two tabs so I could easily navigate to between them. You could also put them side by side if you like. So the first thing is going to be EC3. And in the first task, we are going to create an EC3 bucket and enable and clear look all public access, or enabling public access. And then we want to enable the static website. So I'm going to do that just now. I'm calling my bucket website, and let me call it based on the date of today. And I will add main, and I will explain why I call this main later on when we do the data replication, allow public access, and then I will create the bucket. There is acknowledge for public access. Create a bucket. Then we want to go to the bucket itself, go to the properties, go back to the steps, and we want to have a static website hosting enabled. So we go all the way down, edit, and enable. In the main index, it's going to be called index.html. How I know that? Because the EC3 has index.html. So copy this name of the file here, and then I will save the changes. We want to upload the content of the EC3 to the bucket, so we are going to upload. So you can add files, or you drag and drop your files here. Try this, it's much easier. I will drag and drop them here, and then upload. Now this should upload the two folders I have and the index.html file that I do have. While this finish uploading, let's go back, and it now asking us to answer the first question in the multiple choice. To access them, you need to go to the details, show. And from the show, you will have an access to the multiple choice question. And the question now is, when viewing the website after task 3, do you see the page in a browser? How we can verify? Go back to your bucket, finish uploading. Now go to the properties. And this is our website URL. Open it. You can see 403 error. So the answer to this is going to be no. And submit. Go back again to my task, and we want now to create a bucket policy. Now this is sounds complicated because we want to allow people to access our main website in this bucket. So we have to go to read about this in the AWS documentation. Let me open this in a new tab. And one of the things you want to do is to grant read only permission to any user. And this is an example of that bucket policy that we can use. If you read the lab instruction, it's asking you as well to do just that. grant read only permission to public anonymous users. And this is what we are going to do. We will go back to our AWS console, and from the AWS console properties, and you have in the properties a tab for permission. We want to edit public policy. So we are going to do edit. And this basically, guys, is a resource-based policy, or what sometimes we call it inline policy. We want to paste the policy that we copy from the documentation, and we change the ARN, which is the Amazon resource identifier, with our example packet. Could change the date if you want for the version, and then we can save the changes. All good. Now go back to your website for the packet URL, refresh, you will be able to see that the website is functional and active for the cafe. The other challenge is to protect the website data, and protecting the website data is going to be happened by enabling versioning. And when you enable versioning in your bucket, this makes sure any old version will be kept, and we can use lifecycle policy to copy it to another tier or another class of S3, or we can also replicate it to our backup S3 bucket. So in this task, we are going to enable versioning. So let me go to the console again. And from the properties, this is how we enable versioning. You do bucket versioning, enable, and then save changes. Now the next thing, they want us to open the content of the website. I'm going to use Visual Studio here. And we will add and update a few files here. So we are going to update the first thing we need to update is the background color in the index.html file. So we can use Notepad, you can use any text editor for that. So we are going to change the color from aquamarine to Gainsboro, and so on, from orange and so on. You can easily find this color, which is here. I'm going to change it to this lovely one. And the orange here is going to be changed with this color. I'm just copying and pasting them because just to save time. And the last thing we are going to change is this color in this tab, which basically are going to change the color that we have here in this table in those rows. Go back to Visual Studio and save the file. Then if you go back to the instruction, they are going to ask us to upload the index.html file to our S3 bucket again. So let me go to my AWS console, to objects, and then upload, add a file, add index.html, and open. Then upload. The file is successfully uploaded. I just enabled versioning, so you can see now this is the existing, the first version of the file, and this is the second one, which I just upload. Now, if I refresh the page, I should be able to see the difference in the color. Now, if you want, you can answer question number 2. Go back to the multiple choice URL, and if you notice, what is another way to ensure maximum protection and prevent accidental deletion of a preserved version? It is going to be via multi-factor authentication. How we know that? Go back to the console, go back to the properties, and you can see multi-factor authentication for deletion protection. So you can enable it here from the properties of the bucket, submit this one, and let's go back to the lab. The third challenge is to set up a life cycle policy using 2 rules. The first rule, we want to move a previous version of all source bucket to S3 standard infrequent after 30 days. So to do so, let's do them one at a time. We go to the management. We have a life cycle rules. We create a life cycle rule and we call it first rule. Now I want to apply this to all objects in the bucket. I'm not going to move the current version. I'm going to move the non-current version to standard any frequent access after 30 days and then create that rule. Go back to the instruction. In the second one, we want to delete all the previous rules, the previous version of the object after 365 days. So we're going to create another one and we call it second rule. Apply, and this is going to be delete expired object, permanently delete a non-current version of the object after 365 days, and then create a rule. So we have now two lifecycle rules. The first one is going to move the previous version of any file to standard infrequent access after 30 days, and the second one to delete any previous version of any file permanently will be deleted after 365 days. Could confirm that you have, this is what exactly you did in your asset tree bucket lifecycle policy by reading this paragraph here. You can also now read about the Will Architecture Framework, and one of the things we want to achieve in any architecture is basically to achieve high level of durability. How we can do that to achieve the maximum level of disaster recovery, just in case if our first bucket in our first region deleted, accidentally damaged, crashed, we can have a copy of our website in a second one. To complete task 7 successfully, we need to go back to our bucket S3, and now we need to create a new bucket. I'm going to call this website replication, the date of today, -2021, and I'm going to create this one in the Irish region. I want to enable versioning per instruction. If you go here, they are saying we need to create a new bucket and we need to enable versioning in it, and then we need to create a replication for that bucket. So we create it now, go back to AC3, select the original main bucket that you have, and then from the management, create a replication rule. In the replication rule, we need to enter a rule name. So this is replication rule. By default, it's going to be enabled. Now, this is our source bucket. So we choose the scope. It's going to apply for all objects. And our destination, we can select it from the list here. So our replication rule in the Irish region is going to be the destination of our replication. We need to select the cafe role, and as you can see in the instruction, this basically allow us to move all objects from the source bucket to the destination bucket. And be careful here, because this only apply to any modification we do after the rule is active in the source bucket. The next thing is going to be save the rule. And if you go back to the instruction, now we want us to answer question number 3. Got to go back. Any question number 3, do you see the objects from your source bucket in the destination bucket? You can verify, but the answer is going to be no, because we have done no modification to the source bucket yet. So if you open, you can't see any modification. So go back to the question, answer question 3, and now go back and we need to make minor changes in the index.html. I'm going to go to Visual Studio and I will make a small paragraph here above the table after replication is enabled. Save, and then go back to the console, to the main web replication to the main bucket, I'm going to upload the index.html file again. Upload. Verify, you can see my changes here. Now, once we activate this with the replication, what will happen is the destination bucket of our replication, it will receive the new version of the file index.html. You could also verify this by deleting some files, deleting some images, or adding a new content to your source bucket until you manage to see it in the replication. So you can see now the new content of index.html is here in the replication file. Okay, so let's go back and we need to answer question number 4, which is, was the version that you just deleted from the source bucket also deleted from the destination bucket? The answer is yes. Was the version that you just deleted from your source bucket also deleted from your destination bucket? Yes, because the replication means if we delete this object here in our asset tree bucket, let's try that before we can judge. Delete this file. I'm going to just delete the cafe owner image. Now, if you go back to your ST3, to the replication, refresh, you can't see this image here. What you could do to verify is going to back to the images and upload it again, the image we just delete. This is the cafe owner. I'm going to upload it to the bucket, and you will see that this image now, after it will be uploaded, it will appear now in the replication. So go back. Go to the replication. Now this make, sometimes it take a few times to the replication to appear. Just verify that the website is still active. So this is the image I delete. Be obvious to see it here. And you can see now in the images, I can see the cafe owner. So if you want, was the version that you just deleted from your source bucket also deleted from your destination bucket? The answer for this is going to be no. And submit. You can feel free to submit your work, and that's all of the challenge lab for creating static website. Thank you very much.